People just love Caddo Lake. Caddo Lake gets in your blood. It's like a prehistoric environment with the bald cypress trees and the Spanish moss hanging down. It's beautiful and people love it. When it's under attack like this, it really alarms people. This is a wetland of international significance. And we're involved in a desperate fight to save it from this most aggressive plant in the world.
Giant salvinia is a threat to Caddo Lake. I'm Tim Bister, and I'm a fisheries biologist for Texas Parks and Wildlife. Caddo Lake is known as the only natural lake in Texas, so it is one of our gems that we really want to be able to protect. Giant salvinia is a floating aquatic fern from South America. It grows very rapidly. It can actually double in size in 4 to 7 days. Giant salvinia first showed up in Caddo Lake in 2006 on the Louisiana side at one of the boat ramps. The worst year that we've had, there was about 6,000 acres of giant salvinia covering the Texas side of Caddo Lake. That's about half of the water that we have. There were areas that were so completely covered by giant salvinia and the plants growing on top of the salvinia mats that it looked like dry land. The main river channel that travels through Caddo Lake was completely covered by giant salvinia. There were many areas that you couldn't get a boat through. There were lots of people that were very concerned about the lake, and it was a year that growth was so bad, there just really wasn't a lot that could be done.
You can see where they sprayed.
There's lots of dead. Dead is good.
I'm John Findeisen. I'm an aquatic invasive species biologist. This is an area where we sprayed. State contractors had come in here and done some herbicide treatments on this and really pushed the salvinia back. And then we're using a combination of both the systemic herbicide that'll circulate throughout the plant, as well as a contact herbicide that just burns wherever it touches. It's still slowly dying, falling out. What green plant is alive, our contractors are coming in and spraying.
The best strategy for invasive species management is using an integrated approach, using as many tools in your toolbox to control a situation.
We've been using a combination of herbicides here recently with great success in the management of the species and being able to maintain the open water. In addition to that, we've been trying for well over a decade now of using biocontrol, the giant salvinia weevil. It's a species-specific weevil, just feeds on giant salvinia and can control it. We've seen control out here in several places. Parks and Wildlife raises and releases their own weevils, but we really need a lot of people doing that. And here recently, the Caddo Biocontrol Alliance has stepped up, releasing large numbers of weevils to help with this control.
We are in uncertain Texas at Caddo Lake, and what we are doing is raising giant salvinia weevils to control the giant salvinia plant, the invasive aquatic plant that is trying to take over Caddo Lake. We wanted to build this greenhouse, mass produce these weevils and get them out onto the water in large numbers as we can. We're weevil ranchers. These are the tanks where we grow the giant salvinia. We introduce the weevils onto the salvinia here in a controlled environment. We raise them, and when the population gets to the right level, we actually take the salvinia from here, put it into totes, go out to where the giant salvinia is, and release these weevils into the environment. It's hot, hard work. And this greenhouse in the summertime is extremely hot. And Texas summers, you know, the temperature gets up over 100 degrees. It takes people who really love the environment, who love the lake and love the area, to give so much time and work and effort and sweat to protect the lake.
Morning. How y'all doing?
All
these are going on the pontoon, right?
A lot of those people are the local people that live and utilize the lake out here. They care because they live out here. They're out here every day, and this is their home. They pour their heart and soul into managing this salvinia in the lake to keep it from taking over.
Oh, it's beautiful. And the water, since the grass has died, the water is perfect all over the lake to fish. It's a great place. It's a magical lake. Isn't it, Leah?
I think the future of Caddo is bright. I think a lot of people are going to be able to enjoy the lake like they always did, like the good old days they talked about.
It's extremely brittle, but something was eaten on it.
We are seeing evidence of either a moth larva or the weevil damage itself.
It is frustrating having an invasive species that just won't go away, knowing that no matter what we do, we're never going to get rid of giant salvinia at Caddo Lake. But I do have the hope that our efforts are going to help continue to keep boaters having the ability to get around the lake, to have anglers still have their places that they like to fish. Native plants will come back. Fish will be able to use more of the lake. Ducks will have open water to land on. It's all tied together.